I'll get baby birds. You hear him? I found him in the parking lot. His name is Super Chicken. And he is so little. And everybody was just walking by him. It was hot. And Nate was just going to leave him there to die.
I know how to take care of him. But I brought him home. Some of the basic stuff you're going to need. This is called Exact. See that? It's your baby bird feed. Any kind of baby bird, you know, whether it's parrots, little wild birds, until they can feed on their own. You mix it in a little container so he knows it is supper time. He's been eating it, so he knows it's stuff. You mix about half and half of some water. It's got grit and grain. Grit is the sand and the grit that baby birds like him need. Because unlike a stomach digestive tract like we got, he has what's called a gizzard. And he needs that grit to go into his gizzard. When he eats seeds, that's how they grind up the seeds and digest them. So you're trying to eat the beads off my bracelet because it's shiny like a seed. And so that also tells me he's getting ready to start eating regular bird seed. And when you see them out on the street and they're picking around and it's like they're eating nothing, what they are is they're picking up little microscopic, it's not microscopic, but tiny little bits of sand and rock and stuff like that to get into their gizzard to grind a piece of seed and stuff. Got onto the idea of the dropper. Use an eyedropper to get in any pharmacy. I'll show you what they look like. Because that's a pharmacist, she'll give them to you. Does that cost anything? Just like that, she'll go behind a counter. She needs to charge you a dollar, whatever for them. No big deal. I went the other day and she gave me 3 of these. I told her I was going to use them to feed baby birds. She said no problem. Eventually, he'll get better at eating himself, but now you actually have to open his little mouth and put it down there. I'll demonstrate that later. He's not really hungry now. When they get hungry, you'll see their wings will start flapping like they're still kind of involuntarily. They should always be doing that because he always should be exercising his wings because he's got to get out in the big world and fly. Also, another reason I'm doing this and putting it on YouTube is I hope there's a lady out there on the talk show named Ellen DeGeneres. She's a really big fan of animals and animal lover. She's a pretty powerful person. I'm going to raise him to be big enough to fly, and I'm going to release him. But I'm trying to bring attention to the fact that I see these pigeons out on the street all the time, and they don't have any feet. And the reason they don't have any feet is because us humans put out these chemicals, the sticky stuff that's supposed to keep them off of our buildings and our ledges and our windows and our apartment patios and stuff like that. It doesn't keep them away. All this gets stuck to their little feet. And if they survive the agony of having that part of their foot rot off or have to chew it off themselves, you see them all over the city where they don't have nothing but a little mug. Very few pigeons you see out in the city now. They have all their toes and all their feet.